Hi friends of Lower Primary and welcome to a new week of Performing Arts. So we will continue with our Mamma Mia work today. I've started to get some videos in of people showing me what they've been doing at home and they are splendid. Fabulous. Get it? Abba? Fabulous? Terrible joke. All right, moving on, let's start to do our warm up. So check long hair is back. You've got plenty of space to move around, comfy clothes on and water nearby. Let's get warm. Let's start with our first movements to help with our vocal warm up. So we're gonna move our body first. And I know you're thinking, well, it's not a vocal warm up, but it just loosens the body because we need to involve all the body when we sing. So let's start with some gentle shoulder rolls back. We'll do a proper dance warm-up in a moment too, as well. And some shoulder rolls forward. Very nice. And we will just swing our head from side to wake the neck up, because of course this is where all our vocal cords are. All the way around and the other way. And hopefully you have your feet planted on the ground. And they're nice and solid to help us stay grounded when we sing, but we need to loosen the knees up a little bit, so we'll just bend and stretch the knees. Lovely jubbly. All right, so now we're gonna think about the mouth and how we're going to warm that up. And we're gonna start with a big fake yawn that leads into a sigh. So let me show you first. It's gonna go. So we're opening the mouth as big as we can, and I'm sure grown-ups have told you, put your hand over your mouth when you yawn. But we're not really yawning, are we? We're doing like a fake yawn to warm ourselves up, so don't even worry about it, ready? So join me with this yawn. We go. And into a nice smiley sigh. Try that one more time. Now we're ready to start making some sounds. Lip trills are where we move the lips and they vibrate together very, very quickly at the same time. And this is excellent for warming up the lips. So let me show you. It will go a little bit like this. Can you do that? It's like forcing air forward and making the lips vibrate back and forward together. Give that a try. Any note, any tune, just push forward and see if you can get those lips to trill. Here we go. And the more you practice, the better you will be. Shall we try now our siren, which is where we go low, high, and low with the lip trill. Ready? Ooh, I lost it at the end. I haven't been singing over the holidays. And now you can tell. Let's try. Okay, and you can even try doing a song with lip trills. So I think I'll probably stop halfway through because it may or may not work. Let's try. We are here to try. Let's try the tune of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star in lip trills. Ready to join with me? One, two, three, and. It's gone. Mrs. Bates, sort it out. Did you manage it? That's one to practice. We'll try that more than once and see if we can get any better doing it. All right, team, let's get warm. Let's start with a bounce from side to side. Nice and light on the toes. We're gonna jump in and out. In and out and bounce around. Let's do that again. In and out. All the way. All right. It walks forward. Come to me. One. And back. Let's do it in four. One, two, three, four. And we go to the side. Nice and bouncy. Let's do one. Turn around, and again, two, one, and around the way. Let's squat to warm up those knees. Knees over toes. And play that sax. That wasn't a saxophone, was it? Never mind. Crazy hands. Wow. Shoulders. Two back. And two forward. Let's do big arms. Circle back. And forward. Let's go again with the in and out. And around. Nice and fancy to make sure we're warm. And in. Other way. In, walk forward. Set and left. In, forward. One, two, three, four. And chorus. Two. And two. One, two. And again. Let's squat. Crazy arms. Shoulders. And two forward. All right, let's do those big arm circles. Forward, backwards, and forward. And again. Let's do our chorus one more time. Nice and bouncy. One, and a two. One, two, and squat. Play it. Down again. And we rock crazy arms. And we finish with a big breath in. And out. Hopefully you're nice and warm. Mr. Chop's sweet shop is where we pretend we go into a sweet shop. Pretend we remember those days when we didn't have to wear masks. Oh, the good old days. Well, we are going to pretend we go into a sweet shop. And Mr. Chop gives us different types of sweets. And we show all over our face how we're eating those sweets. So, the first sweet you get from Mr. Chop is a gobstopper. Put your gobstopper in. Excellent. Move that mouth around. Your gobstopper is huge. Use all your cheeks. You have to keep sucking the flavour off until it gets smaller and smaller so you're able to eat it. Use all that face. Has it got smaller yet? Oh, when you're ready, give it a big gulp down. Oh, the gobstopper's gone. Right, Mr. Chop, what have you got for us next then? The next sweet we get from Mr. Chop is really, really sour. Oh my goodness, it's all in your mouth. It's hitting the roof of your mouth. Your tongue is sizzling. Oh my goodness, keep chewing it. I hope it'll go away. Oh, okay. Sour sweet's gone. I'm not sure I'm going to trust Mr. Chop with another sweet. Should we give him a try? Give him a chance. All right, let's get our final sweet off Mr. Chop. Let's see what it is. It's delicious. Show me with your face. A delicious sweet. It's in your eyes and your eyebrows. You're almost smiling at the same time as chewing. You don't want it to end. And it's all gone. Okay, friends, so it's time to crack on with our money, money, money song. So let's sing what we've got so far. And I told you last time, we've got all the tune in the bag. It's wrapped up. So we know the whole tune now. We just have to add some new words on to expand our story as Donna or Don. So let's have a crack at what we've got so far. And we'll add some more on. Piano. Here we goal.
I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay. Ain't it sad? And still there never seems to be a single penny left for me. That's too bad.
In my dreams,
I have a plan. I'd win the lotto, I know I can. I wouldn't have to work at all.
Atrocious. I can only apologise. But you know what happened? I'll let you in on a little secret. Mrs. Bates, with actually the epic help of Mrs. Nelson of PE fame, we've been doing a little bit of changing the old words, haven't we? Because you're kids. And then it was all about finding a man, and we don't need to. I mean, come on, guys. You're like five or something. So, me and Mrs. Nelson have put on the songwriter's hats. We have transformed to Benny and Bjorn, and we have changed the words. And I was singing the old words, and then it put me off, and then I went out of tune. Yoop, zip it up. So, the new words, Mrs. Bates, are a plan like that is hard to find, but I can get it off my mind. We're talking about the plan of winning the lotto, yes? Remember, we won the lotto, we were thinking about it and all the things we could do with our money. So now it comes back down to that dark bit of, she kind of changes her mind again. She's thinking it's really hard. I mean, to win the lotto is really difficult. Like, the chances are very slim, right? So then she's back on a negative sadness. A plan like that is hard to find, but I can't get it off my mind. Ain't it sad? Exactly the same tune as, I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay. Ain't it sad? Yes, a plan like that is hard to find, but I can't get it off my mind. Ain't it sad? Same tune, and then the same as the first verse again. And if it happens to be me, I try to grow a money tree. That's too bad. So if it happens to be me that wins, I try to grow a money tree. Do we know how to grow trees, people? When you put like seeds in the ground. I think Donna, in mine and Mrs. Nelson's mind, because we changed the words, is going to plant a little bit of her lotto winnings in the ground and try and grow money trees so even more money would come. Oh my goodness. But she hasn't got enough money at the moment to do that. She can't risk it in case it doesn't work. She hasn't got much money. But if her plan works off, she's going to try and grow a money tree. That's too bad. Is like, she hasn't got it right now. Okay? So exactly the same tune as the first verse, but we've got these words. So let's try and get these words in our mind without worrying about the tunes. Let's just do the rhythm. Bum, bum, a plan like that is hard to find, but I can't get it off my mind. Ain't it sad? Two, three, four. And if it happens to be me, I try to grow a money tree. One, two, that's too bad. Wait, wait, wait. Okay, so just same tune, new words. Let me try and find that bit with the tune, and we'll get these words practiced. Try to grow a money tree. try that bit one more time, just the new bit. And then I wonder if we can add it all on together. And let's have a little try of that, okay? So from that same part again.
Rich man's world.
Let's try our new bit. Ready?
One, two, three. A plan like that is hard to find, but I can't get it off my mind. Ain't it sad?
And if it happens,
and if it happens to be me, I try to grow a money tree. That's too bad.
Got it? And now you start to think of your face and your body, what you can do. Amazing. We have got time to try it once from the Nativity, which is the top, the beginning, all the way up to our new bit. And let's see how we get on. Oh my goodness, this is so exciting. Right, I'll press play on this and I'll move the words back. Deep, 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 deep. There we are. Ready? So channel your inner Donna O'Don. We're working, we're exhausted. Oh. So we face the back, all the front, pointy fingers, 8 steps. Bum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum. Turn around. Bum ba 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 ba. 5, 6, 7. Great big rock star guitar. Half, half and all the way around. Rock star guitar. Half, half and all the way around. And then when the ladies start singing, Anietta and Frieda, we come forward with our cross points. I say Anietta and Frieda because I'm in ABBA mode. Who sings this in? I think Donna sings it in the musical. Cross forward 4 times. I've been cheated by you since I don't know them. We've got our shoulders. Bing, 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 bing. Step, turn and jump and clap. Then we go backwards. So I've made up my mind. It must come 3 shoulders. Bing, 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 bing. Step. Turn, jump, and clap. And then our new bit last week was look at me now. And we look, don't we? We separate our feet to a jazz second, which is feet apart. We go around, look at me now. Then we ask the question, will I ever learn? Then we go the other way. I don't know how, but I certainly. And then we've got the pivot turn thing, which I think I did this, but I'm going to do fingers if I remember. Certainly lose control. And you know what else I did? I told you to do four and there's only three. Come on, Mrs. Bates. It was that end of week feels that I just forgot. So three, lose control. Three, so you're going to need to do bigger steps to get all the way around. And then we'll add on a new bit today. Let's try what we've got so far, people. Get us moving and then we'll add some on. From the tippity. Here we go. And. Nice big guitar. We go hop, hop all the way. Bring it forward, team. Shoulders. Step, turn, jump, up and back. Shoulders. Look and ask. Other way. And we turn around. There's a fire within my soul is next. Hopefully you got there all the way around. Lose control. Then I'm going to join our feet together. Do a nice big circle with our arms. There's a fire that's going to take us down to the floor within my. And then on soul, we're going to do, we're going to come up with our arms coming forward. But it has to be done, team. Jazzy hands. If you don't know what a jazz hand is, who are you for a start? Where have you been? Secondly, it's literally, just think of your little finger and your thumb, and they change between, like, imagine there's like little drums in front and they've got a hit, little finger hit, bit thumb, duh, 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 and they change between which one goes in front, and they do it quicker and quicker and quicker, and that, my friends, is a movement classic, jazz hand. So, and that's on the way back up, okay? So we're gonna go big arms down to the floor, jazzy hands up. And the words to that bit from the lose control goes, ever I suddenly lose control. There's a fire within my soul. I think I'm singing the wrong tune. So fire within my soul. Okay, so we've got some nice levels there, adding some groundwork, because it's all been pretty much on the same level at the moment, and we looked at that last year. So let's get down in the ground, and then our next bit's jumping, so we'll get a high level in there as well, okay? Shall I try and find that bit from bam, ba, da, 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 and add the new bit on, yes? Let's have a look. So cross points coming forward, here we go, 6, 7, and 3, shoulders, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, step, turn, jump, clap and back, shoulders, and look, other way, control, and on we go, new bit, there's a fire within my soul. Got it? Oh, and then the drama starts. Where are we on time-wise? Yes. I hope you got that there. I think what I'll do is I'm only going to go that far today. Nice and easy. It's the beginning of the week. Let's ease ourselves in. And I'm conscious of time as well. So shall we try it once from the beginning all the way through? And then we'll add some more on Thursday. Brilliant. All right. Choose whether you're going to face the back or the front, pointy fingers. Here we go. Straight in. And turn around. Nice big guitar. And hop, hop, all the way around. Hop, hop, all the way around. Cross point. Shoulders. Shoulders! to wait on Thursday. Stay with me, kids, and we'll do that on Thursday. All right, people, hope you enjoyed our new bit. Well done. Let's move on to some drama. Okay, everyone, and welcome to the drama slot for today. Now, if you remember last week, we started to become the character by changing our hair, if you could, and our clothing. Maybe finding some costume that would suit that character, or finding some props around the house. Props are handheld items that your character might hold, okay? That can be something like a phone, a notepad and pen maybe, if they were like a journalist, an umbrella. Up at Prime, we've been doing Mary Poppins, and I got some pictures of some lovelies with umbrellas in their hand. Anything that you think might help you to become the character more. So if you remember, last week we looked at Ms. Donna, that was one of your choices. And your second choice, we were introduced to Sam, which is one of Sophie's potential fathers. So this lesson, I'm going to give you two more new characters, and then it's over to you to become that person. You can choose which one, or you can do both if you like. We'll find out a little bit about the character, and then you go away, try and make your hair like them. You can try and find some things around the house maybe that they would wear or that they would carry, and see how natural it comes to you to have a conversation with somebody as that character. So you're not you anymore, you have to become them, okay? So our first choice for today is Ms. Sophie, which you could argue is the main character, or certainly one of the main characters. Sophie is 21 years old, so if you played Donna or Sam last time, you are half their age, so a bit younger, so you have to think about how you're going to act that out. Maybe like a university student age, if that helps you to think. So they are much older than you, but not as old as Donna and Sam. She is American, if you can do an American accent. She's always lived on this small island of Greece. So maybe that will help you decide to like maybe wearing some like hot clothes, like, you know, sunny clothes, summer clothes. You can see she's got like little shorts and a little top on here. So if you want to be like a Sophie type character, just bear in mind she's always lived on a hot island. She is the daughter of Donna, as we know already. She wants a traditional family because she never had one. When she grew up, she didn't have a father around, and that's fine, that works. But she would love to have her own child and a father figure there as well. And she is young, strong, and energetic. So she knows her own mind, she's strong, she's got loads of energy because she's young and she wants to see the world as we know. And you also know she's going out of Sky, right? And they're about to get married. So if you'd like to be Sophie, have a think about what you would wear, look at what her hair's like, and how you would act if you were this person. Your second choice for today is potential father number two, Mr. Bill. And this is what Bill looks like. Some sort of colourful array of shirt there, people, if you can find one in your own wardrobe or maybe your mum or dad's. So Bill is 40 to 50 year old, so the same as Donna and Sam. In the musical, he's normally got either an English accent or Australian. G'day, mate. That's terrible. I can't do that. We know Mrs. Bates and accents don't go together very well. Maybe you guys don't know so well, but the Mary Poppins upper primary. It's not working out for me, but I am trying. So English or Australian, you guys can give that a go. His job is a travel writer. So that means he goes all around the world and all these great, crazy places. And then he writes articles, maybe like the best food to eat at this place or the best must-see places to go to. You know, you can imagine, so he is around the world all the time and then writing about it. So that's a really interesting point if you'd like to act like Bill. Could be Sophie's dad, as we know, potential father number two. He could never commit to a family. So while he's traveling the world, he didn't want to settle down, and maybe that's what happened between him and Donna. He just couldn't settle down on this little Greek island. He wanted to go and see lots of places. Lots of comedy. You guys are going to smash this because you're all so hilarious. And a golden heart, which means he means really well. He'd do anything for anyone. So this is your second choice for today. You might want to find yourself a little checky shirt. Might want to give yourself a side pardon. Don't know if you know, I've got a haircut at the weekend here. People look at that. Side part in hairdo. You're going to have to try some accents out. And how could you be full of comedy, golden heart, travel writer person? I will leave that up to you. It's your turn to go and choose one of those characters to be now. Try having a conversation with mum or dad or a brother or sister as Bill or Sophie. Pause the video, come back when you're done, and we will cool down together. Good luck, actors. All right, everybody, we've worked so hard today. Well done for coming home from school and doing more lessons. I hope you've had fun, but now it's time for our cool down. So let's start with our feet together. And we take a nice deep breath in. And let go of that deep breath. And let's do that one more time. Nice breath in. And as we let go, we're going to move our top of our body down towards the floor. So try to keep those knees straight and stretch to the floor. Let's bend the knees a little bit. Try and touch the floor. And as we stretch, can we keep our fingers where they were? Try that again. And stretch. Lovely. All right, let's move down to the floor. And that's what you've done. So we will start with our frog position. This is our, the soles of our feet joined together. And we let our knees flop out. Think of a piece of string at the top of the head. Up and stretching over. A bit wild there, wasn't she? Let's stretch one leg out and keep the other leg bent. Piece of string at the top of the head, up, and stretch over that leg. All right, coming up, let's swap our legs. Other leg in front. Piece of string, up, and over. Okay, now we're going to take our legs out to our second position. So as wide as they will go, but keeping them nice and straight, with knees sitting up to the ceiling, so they're not curling in and turning out. All right, we take one arm up, stretch up, and over the top we go. All right, let's do that the other side. Other arm up. Stretch your eyes and eye and over. Does it feel the same when she calls your name? All right, this time we're going to turn the shoulders and the chest towards the leg and try to hold on to that foot if you can. But I have lost a lot of flexibility over the holidays. I'm going to need to work on that a little bit. Oh, let's be brave and go through the middle. Walking then, hands forward. Can you get your belly to the floor? I know I can't. Stretch. All right, let's bring that back up. Shake the legs in. Ooh. Okay, let's bring ourselves onto our knees. Up to our toes, and we're gonna stretch the legs and try and keep the hands on the floor. Up we go. See if you feel any bend yet. And take the legs out to second, so stretched apart. And we'll come with the dramatic long note. All right, let's try our quad stretch, which is where we catch the foot with our hand, and we put our heel to our bottoms with our knees joined together. So Hilary, you might want a wall to lean on if you need to, or you can put your arm out to help with your balance. All right, let's stretch the arms, cross the chest, and hook it in. Other side. Let's take that arm up, flop at the elbow, and bring it in. We're losing it. Other arm, up, flop, and in. Let's take it back before we get some sort of random, that'll do. Some random advert or song that isn't appropriate. Okay, let's end it there with our nice big breath. So deep breath in. And again, deep breath in. And we take our final breath in. Take our hands to our heart space. It's a great lesson today, team. See you next time.